You use a computer so that it will do the boring, mundane work for you, right? So the next time you need to add a bunch of bullets or numbers in front of a list of paragraphs, don't type them manually. It's far more efficient to let InDesign add them for you. I have my long document file open, and let's press Option or Alt page down to jump to the next spread. Now, I'll double-click to switch to the Type tool, and I'll select a bunch of this text over here. Now, let's press Command or Control Plus a couple of times to zoom in on this. To add bullets, up here in the Control Panel, we want to make sure we're in paragraph formatting mode, so I'll select that. Then, to add the automatic bullets, I'm going to come over here to the middle of the panel and just click the Add Bullet button. That's it! The bullets get added automatically, and the bullets are all set up with what's called a hanging indent. See how the bullet hangs out here in the left margin, and the text flows indented to the right of it. So now, the main problems that I see are that the bullet is hanging really far away from the text, and also we're using these really dumb-looking round bullets. Everybody uses round bullets. I want to use something with a little bit more flair. So to change those bullets, we need to get to the Bullets dialog box. And to get there, just hold down the Option or the Alt key when you click on that button again. By holding down the modifier key, we get options for what our bullets are going to look like. Up at the top, we see a number of bullet characters that we could use. The regular old round one, that's the one that's selected. There's this asterisk or diamond, I'm not sure who would use those. This is kind of an interesting one, kind of a double angle bracket. Let's select that. Then I'll turn on the preview checkbox and move this dialog box out of the way. You can see that that looks kind of interesting. There's this other bullet character inside the dialog box, which is really weird. Looks like an A with some accents. I have no idea what that thing is, but I did finally figure out why it shows up for some people and not for others. If you're curious, go to my website, which is creativepro.com, and use the search field to look for weird bullet character. It's kind of an interesting story. Anyway, if you see that, you can just ignore it. But look at all these blank boxes. Those are for you to make your own custom bullets. Let's try it. I'll click on the Add button. Now, bullets are always characters from within a font, so you need to tell InDesign which font you want to pull the character from. In this case, let's choose a font that has a lot of interesting ornaments, Minion Pro. I'll just type MIN and it guesses. Now, I'll change the font style to regular. You can see all the different characters that are inside that font, so I'm just going to scroll down here a little bit till I see a character I like. I like that one, this triangle shape. Let's use that for a bullet. I'll click OK, and you can see it shows up here in the dialog box, where I can select it. Now the last thing we need to do is change these indents down here. This is how you get that hanging indent effect, by the way, a positive left indent and a negative first line indent. Let's change that first line indent to minus 1p. Obviously, you can use millimeters or any other measurement system here. That looks good, so let's click OK and click out here to deselect. See, it wasn't so hard to get cool bullets after all. But how about automatic numbers? Well, see up here in the control panel? Just below the bullet button is the numbering button. So let's go ahead and select those paragraphs again, and this time I'll click on the number button. If you're into web design, you probably call these ordered lists. Now, if it's a very simple list like this, you're done. That's all you need to do. And the good news is that this will update automatically. So, for example, if you click at the end of this paragraph here and just start typing some other text, it all renumbers automatically. Now, let's say you didn't want that paragraph to be part of the list. It's easy to turn that number off. Just go back up to the control panel and click on that button again. Now that paragraph is not being numbered. And if you wanted this paragraph number 4 to start over at number 1 again, all you need to do is click inside that paragraph and then right-click or control-click with a one-button mouse and then choose Restart Numbering from the context menu. Now you see 1, 2, 3, and then it starts over at 1 again. Now if you need to do anything more complex with numbering than what I just showed you, you need to visit the Numbering dialog box. So I'm going to press Command-Z or Control-Z a few times to get back to where I was. Then I'll select all that text again, and this time I'm going to hold down the Option or Alt key when I click on the Numbering button. The dialog box has changed to show me features having to do with numbering. Now a lot of this is self-explanatory, like you can set these numbers to be Roman numerals or even letters. You can even choose a character style to apply to the numbers. That'll change the text formatting of the numbers. We happen to have a couple created in this document, so I'll choose one of these styles here. If you look closely, you can see that InDesign applied that style to the numbers and the dot that follows them. That looks great. Super simple, super quick. Letting your computer update your bullets and numbering is the smart way to use InDesign so that you can save your time for more important design decisions.